God, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your love. And I pray that that would come out in us. God, that today through this entire service, we have a greater revelation of who you are and how much you love us, Father. We thank you so much. We give it all to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's worship.
Amen. Come on, are you ready to praise him today?
Yes.
All right, come on. Let's lift his name up. He's worthy to be praised. Amen. Come on, everybody, hands together. Here we go.
Impossible through you, thine eyes are open.
just reach out to him today. Father, we believe with all of our hearts that there truly is nothing that's too big for you. No circumstance, no problem that you can't solve it, God. So we just come before you today and we lay down our burdens and our cares. God, you love us so much. Your love endures. You're a good God. So God, we call out to you today with all of our hearts, Lord Jesus. Can we just take a second and just worship before our Father? We receive your love today, God. Your amazing love in our lives. Thank you that you're faithful. We believe in faith today. That there's nothing too big for you, Lord Jesus. God, we're going to focus on his love again. He loves you so much. Will you worship with us today? Come join the song.
Come join the song. Lift your voice. It's heaven and earth.
Father, for you, Lord, worship.
Son of God, you are.
too far gone this morning. He loves you so much. His love covers it all. Just reach out to him today and receive the love of our God, the amazing love of our Lord. God, I thank you for your love. See you again, his love endures.
Oh, his love endures forever.
Stronger than the power of the grave. Never runs out on me. Your love I'd rather love too much than judge too much. If I make a mistake in some area, let me love too much. Can somebody say amen? God help us to show your love, to receive your love. You can't give what you don't have. You can't give what you don't have. So receive his love. It's freely given to you. He loves you. We sing it. We preach it. We read it. He loves you. He loves you. It's on your bulletin. Oh, how he loves you. Receive it. You can't give what you don't have. And our love fails, but God's love never fails. Read 1 Corinthians 13 over and over and over, and you'll realize how far short we really fall from letting his love flow through us. Remember, it's impossible to live the Christian life in your own strength. I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless, yet less I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. The Christ life is him living through you, not you struggling and burning out, trying to do good yourself. Your flesh cannot do it, but yielding your life to him. Hallelujah. My favorite verse next to John 3:16 is Romans 5:17. May it be the theme of this house. That for if by one man's offense death reigned and ruled through the one, meaning Adam, much more, everybody say much more. Much more those who receive the abundance of grace. Not just a little grace, but the whole thing, the abundance of grace, everything it means. Favor, forgiveness, empowerment. Amazing Grace says, grace brought me thus far. Grace empowered me to get through the hell and hot water. Grace kept me. Grace enabled me. There's power in grace. The abundance of grace. Everybody say the abundance of grace. And of course, the gift of righteousness, standing right before God, not because of what we've done, but because of what Jesus did, the finished work of the cross. If we have those things, the abundance of grace that can get us through it, I can do all things, we sang today. And we're right with God because of the gift that he freely gave us. We will reign or rule in life. Life won't rule us, we will rule it. We head towards the depression, we say, I'm not going there, I rule over that, I don't have to live like that. We can rise up because of God's grace and empowerment. So God loved us, that he gave his son, who said, it is finished. And when he said, it is finished, there's nothing else needed. Everything's done. Everything's settled. We've got the abundance of grace to rule in life. You're not a victim. You're a victor. That's the word of God. And his love will never fail and never run out on you. We freely bring our needs to God. God's provided healing. If he can save you, he can heal you. And he is a healer. Karen Rosado, Martinez, is she in church today? Okay. Can't see up here, but that's all right. She was recovering from surgery. It's going well, home, I guess. And that's fine. She's needing to recover very serious. And we're grateful that she's made it through that, believing God to take care of everything that is involved in the physical with her. Amen. No, she'll be back with us and on the worship team back again. Sade's sister is very ill and needing our prayers. We pray for her today. Donald Anderson is tolerating the feeding tube at home. Napoleon and Regina are taking turns coming to church. Napoleon worked all night, just getting at 9:30 this morning. Neither of them are here today, but they send their gifts, their tithes, their grace gifts, and their love. And they're a deep part of this family. We pray for them during this time. Debbie Shields has really gone through it. Her brother has had to have a pacemaker put in. Also her mother at the same time. Brother's home doing better. Mother's in rehabilitation. Her husband also needs prayer. Blood sugar's dropped. He had to be taken to the hospital. Wow. God is a healer. God is a deliverer. A very present help in the time of trouble. Christy Bellinger family is in need of healing in their life today. The Baldwin family needs a touch from God in their family today. Stephanie Chris's stepfather has had a stroke. He cannot speak or walk. These are all family or extended family from our church family. So we pray for them today. In Jesus' name. Brother John Mays is coming to lead us in prayer over these needs. your faith many times. Jesus looked at him. It didn't matter whether they were perfect, whether they would admit it. Their faith made them whole. Only believe. Nothing is impossible to those that believe. We take these needs. Join hands together, would you? Just in a sign of unity and faith together as we take hands and join our hearts. So glad you're here today. You have a need in your heart, just reach out. God is here. And he wants to do the impossible and the natural for you. That's why they call it supernatural. It's above and beyond what is natural. God can do that. Brother John.
Father God, we thank you this morning. Thank you, Father God, for this privilege to come before you, to worship you, to praise you, to honor you, God, in this way. Father God, we thank you for the sweet savor of this praise that is yet in this building. Thank you, Father God, for you said in your word, God, that we should lift our hands in the sanctuary, and we should give you the praise. So God, before we ask anything, we want to praise you, we want to thank you, we want to acknowledge you. We want to bless you today, God. We thank you so much for your sweet spirit in this place. Now, Father God, we see these needs, God, too numerous for me to understand, but God, you know every one of them. Father God, by medical, by miracle, by the surgeon's scalpel, or by your stripes, God, we pray that you would heal and touch and deliver. God, Father God, we know that there is more healing in the hem of your garment than there is in any medicine cabinet, any doctor's office, any hospital in this whole world. So, Father God, we just praise you right now, God, for the victory over these that have been called, God, by our pastor. Father God, touch right now, God. Whatever needs to be done, God, we know that you're capable of doing it, God. Father God, we just thank you right now. Now, Father God, we here in this place as we stand, we have needs, spoken and unspoken, God. So, God, we bring those needs to you, God. Every care, every concern, every problem, every issue, every stumbling block, every hurdle, every obstacle, every fiery dart of the enemy, God, we bring it before you, God. We praise you, God, for what you're going to do, God. We shout now, God, even though we don't see the victory, God. For we know that, God, at the cross, there is victory. There is overcoming. There's grace. There's love. There's peace. There's acceptance. There's forgiveness, Father God. Father God, we're not the victims, God. We're the victors. Father God, we're overcomers by the word of the Lord. We thank you, Father God. Now, God, we just praise you now, God, for what you're going to do for our pastor right now. Pray that you will lift up a word in him, God, that you prepare in him, that we may be receptive hearts, hearing ears. God, that we may go and do what the word says today, God. We just thank you now. We rejoice. We praise you. We lift our hands. We sing hallelujah. And we thank you, Lord. These we ask in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.